اعوذ باللہ من الشیطان الرجیم پناہ لیتا ہوں میں اللہ کی شیطان مردود سے بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم شروع اللہ کے نام سے جو بے حد مہربان نہایت رحم والے ہیں حامیم والکتاب المبین انا انزلناه فی لیلت مبارکت انا کنا منذرین فیہا یفرق کل امر حکیم امرا من عندنا انا کنا مرسلین رحمتا من ربک انہ هو السمیع العلیم رب السماوات والأرض وما بينهما إن كنتم موقنين لا إله إلا هو يحيي ويميت ربكم ورب آبائكم الأولين حامیم قسم ہے اس کتاب واضح کی بے شک ہم نے اس کو اتارا ہے ایک برکت والی رات میں بے شک ہم ڈر سنانے والے ہیں اسی رات میں ہر پختہ امر کا فیصلہ ہوتا ہے یہ حکم ہماری طرف سے ہوتا ہے بے شک ہم ہی بھیجنے والے ہیں رحمت ہے تیرے رب کی طرف سے بے شک وہی سننے والا جاننے والا ہے رب ہے تمام آسمانوں اور زمین کا اور جو کچھ ان کے بیچ میں ہے اگر تم کو یقین ہے اس کے سوا کوئی عبادت کے لائق نہیں وہی جلاتا ہے اور مارتا ہے تمہارا بھی رب ہے اور تم سے پہلے باپ دادوں کا بھی رب ہے حامیم by the book which is full of clarity surely we have revealed this Quran in a night which is most blessed and we were warners in it in this night every matter which has been strengthened is decided it is an order from us surely we are the ones who sent the angels and the messengers and this is a mercy from your Lord surely he is the all-hearing all-knowing Lord of the heavens and the earth and whatever is in between them if you are to believe and have faith there is none worthy of worship besides him he gives death and he gives life He is your Lord and the Lord of your earlier forefathers. These are the opening verses of Surah Al-Dukhan in the 25th chapter. Today we want to have a special session regarding Shab-e-Barat, the 15th night of the month of Sha'ban. That is why we recited these ayat. Because according to some Mufassireen, these ayat are in reference to Shab-e-Barat. Ikrimah, who was the student of Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu, used to say, when Allah says, "Inna anzalnahu fi laylatin mubarakatin, inna kunna munzirin," laylatin mubaraka, the reference is towards the 15th night of Sha'ban. Fiha yufraqu kullu amrin hakeem. All matters are decided in there, meaning the things that are to take place throughout the next year are sorted out and all files are distributed among the angels and they are being given what is about to happen in the oncoming year that takes place in this night. That is why he said that Laylatin Mubaraka and Fiha Yufraqu Kullu Amrin Hakim is referenced to that night. First of all, we have to remember three things over here. Number one, this night falls in the month of Sha'ban. So we need to understand the virtue of the month of Sha'ban. And then the special virtue of the night of Sha'ban. And number three, what types of worship should we do in the night of Sha'ban? First category, first matter, the virtue of Sha'ban. What is the meaning of Sha'ban? In Qamus, it is written that Sha'ban is the word is taken out of Sha'b, which means branch. Shu'bah means branch. So Tasha'aba means to have various branch. And Sha'ban is named with the word because there are various branches and different angles and channels of virtue and good and khair in this month. When a person engages himself in those virtuous deeds, he goes on the path of Jannah and he is taken into Jannah by doing good deeds in this blessed month. That is why it's named Sha'ban. And they named Sha'ban because maybe in this month they used to spread out in different areas as well. Also, they named Ramadan because it fell in the heated season when they were naming the names. That's why they kept the name Ramadan, because Ramadha means the scorching wind and the heated land. So from there they took out the month Ramadan because it fell in the hot months. Anyhow, Sha'ban is taken from Tasha'ud. Regarding the virtue of this month, there are plenty of ahadith. Imam Bayhaqi rahmatullahi alayhi narrates in his Shu'ab from Abu Huraira radiyallahu anhu that Rasul Pak sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Sha'ban bayna Rajab wa shahri Ramadan yaghfulu an-nasu anhu yurfa'u fihi a'malu al-ibad fa uhibbu an la yurfa'a fihi 'amali illa wa ana sa'im. Sha'ban is such a month that it's between Rajab and Ramadan, and people are neglectful of this month. When the a'mal of the servants of Allah are raised and taken to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this month, so I would like my a'mal to be taken to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in such a state that I am fasting and I am sa'im. That's why I keep roza and fast during this month. So Rasulullah Pak sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said here, يَغْفُلُ النَّاسُ عَنْهُ. People don't pay much attention to it. Ibn Rajab al-Hanbali rahmatullah alayhi says, this means that people used to pay much attention to Rajab and to Ramadan, but they used to neglect the month in between Ramadan. In Rajab, they used to perform excessive worship. Even today as well, some people feel that in Rajab there is Shab-e Mi'raj, so they keep special ibadat, special roza, special namaz for the month of Rajab. Some people used to do special sacrifice, which was called a Rajabiyya. And they used to do like we do in Eid al-Adha. So they used to call it Rajabiyya, and they used to special sacrifice like Qurbani Eid al-Adha. So we have to, that is why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that people are neglectful of this month, whereas it has so many virtues. Musnad-e Firdaus al-Daylami narrates from Usama radiyallahu anhu that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Sha'ban shahri wa Ramadan shahrullah. Sha'ban is my month and Ramadan is the month of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ibn Asakir and Ibn Najjar narrate from Aisha radiyallahu anha and Anas radiyallahu anhu that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's habit was that kana Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam idha dakhala Rajab قال اللهم بارك لنا في رجب وشعبان وبلغنا رمضان. O Allah, give us barakat in our times in Rajab and Sha'ban, and give us and let us reach Ramadan. That give us barakat in Rajab, Sha'ban, in everything, in our time, in our amal, in our deeds, and spare us, do not take us before the month of Ramadan comes. Give us the barakat of Ramadan and the barakat of Roza and Taraweeh, and after that, after Shawwal, if you want to take me, you can take me. This was his dua in preparation for Ramadan. Number 4, Imam Bukhari rahmatullah alayhi narrates from Aisha radiyallahu anha, she says, ma ra'aytul nabiyya sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fi shahrin akthara minhu siyaman fi Ramadan. I have not seen that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would keep more fast than what he would keep in the month of Ramadan. In Muslim and Nasa'i, she says, kana yasumu sha'ban illa qalilan. He used to keep roza and fast throughout the month of Ramadan, except for a few days. He would only open his and stay without fasting for a few days. Most of the sha'ban, he would be fasting. In Abu Dawud, it is narrated from her, kana ahabba ash-shuhur ila rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam an yasumahu sha'ban thumma yasiluhu bi Ramadan. That the most beloved month to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam for fasting was Sha'ban, and he would join it with the month of Ramadan. So these are a few virtues. In Nasa'i Sharif number 5, we read from Usama radiyallahu anhu, who says, I said to Rasulullah, ya Rasulullah, lam araka tasumu min shahrin min ash-shuhur ma tasumu min Sha'ban. I have not seen that you fast in any month as much as you fast in Sha'ban. He replied, قَالَ ذَلِكَ شَهْرٌ يَغْفُلُ النَّاسُ عَنْهُ بَيْنَ رَجَبُ وَرَمَضَانُ وَهُوَ شَهْرٌ يُرْفَعُ فِيهِ الْأَعْمَالُ إِلَىٰ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ فَوْحِبُ وَنْ يُرْفَعَ عَمَلِي وَأَنَا صَائِمٌ. That is a month in from which people are neglectful, it is between Rajab and Ramadan, and in that month a'mal are raised to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So I would like that my a'mal are raised to Allah in such a state that I am fasting. Number 6, Ibn Zanjuyah narrated from Aisha radiallahu anha that a lady was mentioned to her that she fasted throughout the month of Rajab. So Aisha said, إِن كُنْتِ صَائِمَةً شَهْرًا لَا مَحَالَةً فَعَلَيْكِ بِشَعْبَانَ فَإِنَّ فِيهِ الْفَضْلَ. If you definitely want to keep Roza and fast, then you should hold on to Sha'ban, because in there is fadl and virtue. Number 7, Aisha radiallahu anha narrates, كان أكثر صيام رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم في شعبان. فقلت يا رسول الله أرى أكثر صيامك في شعبان. قال إن هذا الشهر يكتب فيه لملك الموت من يقبض. فأنا لا أحب أن ينسخ اسمي إلا وأنا صائم. That Rasulullah, you keep so many rozas during the month of Sha'ban. Why is this? And he replied, surely this is such a month that the names of those who are going to die throughout the year are noted down, and the list is being handed over to the angel of death. Therefore, I would love that my name be noted down in such a state that I am fasting, I am doing something good, when my name is recorded in the book of those who are about to die throughout the year. Number 8, Firdaus al-Daylami narrates from Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu that Rasul Pak sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, تُقْطَعُ الْآجَالُ مِنْ شَعْبَانَ إِلَى شَعْبَانَ حَتَّى أَنَّ الرَّجُلَ لَيَنْكِحُ وَيُولَدُ لَهُ وَقَدْ خَرَجَ إِسْمُهُ فِي الْمَوْتَى. That the times and dates are determined in the month from Sha'ban to Sha'ban to such an extent that a person gets married or he has a child born to him, whereas his name is noted down among those who are to die. In another riwayat, حتى أن الرجل يتزوج وقد وقع اسمه في من يموت وإن الرجل ليحج وقد وقع في من يموت. A man gets married, whereas his name is in those who are going to die. He is preparing for Hajj, whereas his name is in those who are going to die. Mm-hmm. In another place, Rasulullah ﷺ said, a person is planting seeds. He is constructing a building or a palace, whereas his name is among those who are going to die throughout the year. So this is why in the month of Sha'ban, these deeds and decrees are determined. And Rasulullah ﷺ said, for this reason, I would like to be in a state of fasting when my decree and my destiny and my fate and taqdeer is being decided. So this is with regards to the virtue of the month of Sha'ban itself. Moving on to the second topic, the night of 15th of Sha'ban, which we in our Indian subcontinent call Shab-e-Barat, Laylatul Bara'at. Why is it called Shab-e-Barat? Because Bara'at means freedom, to free. So in this night, Shab means night, the night of freedom, emancipation. In this night, according to one hadith, hundreds of thousands of people are granted emancipation from the punishment of Jahannam. As we see in the hadith narrated by Imam Ibn Hibban in his Sahih, and he classed it as Sahih, that Aisha radiallahu anha says, فَقَدْتُ النَّبِيَّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ فَخَرَجْتُ فَإِذَا هُوَ بِالْبَقِيعِ رَافِعٌ رَأْسَهُ إِلَى السَّمَاءِ فَقَالَ أَكُنْتِ تَخَافِينَ أَنْ يَحِيفَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْكَ وَرَسُولُهُ فَقُلْتُ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ ظَنَنْتُ أَنَّكَ أَتَيْتَ بَعْضَ نِسَائِكَ فقال إن الله تعالى ينزل ليلة النصف من شعبان إلى سماء الدنيا فيغفر لأكثر من عدد شعر غنم كلب. عائشة رضي الله عنها says, one night I woke up and I missed رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. He was not by my side. So I stood up and went out in search for him. I found him in Baqiul Gharqad, in the graveyard. His head was raised towards the sky and he was making dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He asked me, Aisha, did you fear that Allah and His Rasul would do injustice to you? So I said, Ya Rasulullah, this thought did come to my mind that you have gone to one of your wives leaving me. So Rasul Pak sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, I got out because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes down on the night of the 15th, or on the night, on the middle night of Sha'ban, to the sky of the dunya, to the heaven of the dunya, closest heaven to the dunya, and he forgives so many people which are more than the hair on the sheep and goats of Banu Kalb. So, in another hadith, Rasulullah Pak sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Jibreel alayhi salam came to me and he ordered me to go to Baqi and do istighfar for them. And the reason was because this night Allah's special maghfirat and rahmat is descending. So maybe Allah wanted Rasulullah Pak sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to include those who were buried in Baqi in this maghfirat and in this rahmat. So this is a special night, and because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives so many people and takes their name out of the list of those who are going to go into Jahannam, that is why it's called Laylatul Barad, Shab-e Barad, among our community in the Indian subcontinent. With regards to the fadilat, this hadith we have heard, another hadith narrated by Imam Ibn Majah, Imam Bayhaqi rahmatullahi alayhima, from Ali radiyallahu anhu, that Rasulullah Pak sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِذَا كَانَ لَيْلَةُ النِّصْفِ مِنْ شَعْبَانِ فَقُومُوا لَيْلَهَا وَصُومُوا نَهَارَهَا فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ تَعَالَى يَنْزِلُ فِيهَا لِغُرُوبِ الشَّمْسِ إِلَى سَمَاءِ الدُّنْيَا فَيَقُولُ أَلَا مِنْ مُسْتَغْفِرٍ فَأَغْفِرَ لَهُ أَلَا مِنْ مُسْتَرْزِقٍ فَأَرْزُقَهُ أَلَا مُبْتَلًا فَأُعَافِيَهُ أَلَا كَذَا أَلَا كَذَا حَتَّى يَطْلُعَ الْفَجْرُ. That Rasulullah Pak sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, when it's the middle night of Sha'ban, then stay awake in the night and fast in the day, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descends at the sunset to the sky of the dunya, heaven of the dunya, and then he announces, is there any seeking for forgiveness so I may forgive him? Is there any seeking sustenance so I may provide for him? Is there any afflicted with a problem so I may grant him afiyat and security? Is there any such? Is there any such? And Allah keeps calling out in this manner until Subh-e Sadiq, until dawn strikes and Subh-e Sadiq appears. Shaykh Abdul Haq Muhaddis Dehlavi rahmatullah alayhi writes that if you were to ask that, in another hadith it comes that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes down on the sky of the dunya at in the last portion of every night and makes this announcement, then what is the difference between every night and this night? Then he says the difference is that in other nights Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's announcements takes place in the last portion, maybe the last third of the night. Whereas on Shab-e Barad, the announcement starts immediately from sunset and keeps until the Subh-e Sadiq. That is the difference between this night and other nights. So this is the reason why this night is held in special esteem, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's announcement is being made, and we are told to come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ask for forgiveness, ask for our needs to be fulfilled, and this is the reason. The chain of this hadith might be a bit weak and zaif. However, zaif ahadith are accepted for fadailul a'mal, as is mentioned by our ulama and muhaddithin. Another hadith, Ibn Majah rahmatullahi alayhi narrates from Abu Musa al-Ash'ari radiyallahu anhu, that Rasulullah Pak sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ تَعَالَى لَيَطَّلِعُ لَيْلَةً نِصْفِ مِنْ شَعْبَانِ فَيَغْفِرُ لِجَمِيعِ خَلْقِهِ إِلَّا لِمُشْرِكٍ أَوْ مُشَاحِنٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala looks at his creation in the middle night of Sha'ban, and he forgives his whole creation except for one who is associating partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or one who is holding hatred and malice in his heart. In another narration, وَقَاتِلُ nafs has been added as well, a person who has killed and murdered someone. In another narration, قَاتِعُ رَحِمٍ, the one who cuts off ties and relationship, is also mentioned. Number 4, Imam Bayhaqi narrates with regards to those persons who are not being forgiven on this night as well. Some others that Rasulullah Pak from Abu Thalib al-Khushani radiyallahu anhu, that Rasulullah Pak sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "La yanzuru Allahu fiha ila mushrikin, wala ila mushahinin, wala ila qati'i rahimin, wala ila musbilin, wala ila aqin li walidayhi, wala ila mudmini khamrin, wa fi riwayatin wa zaniyatin bi farjiha wa sahirin." Allah does not look in this night at a person who is committing shirk or holding hatred and malice in his heart, or nor at a person who is cutting off relations, nor at a person who is abusing and hurting his parents, nor at a person who is lowering his garment below the ankles, and nor at a person who is addicted to alcohol, intoxicants, alcoholic, nor at a person who is a woman who is prostituting with her private part, and a person who is doing magic on people. So these people are not forgiven in these nights. Other than these, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives the other categories. Ka'bi Ahbar says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ تَعَالَى يَبْعَثُ جِبْرِيلَ إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ لَيْلَةَ النِّصْفِ مِنْ شَعْبَانَ لِيَأْمُرَهَا أَن تَتَزَيَّنَ. That in the 15th night of Sha'ban, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends Jibreel to Jannah and commands the Jannah to beautify itself and get ready. Maybe this is in preparation for the month of Ramadan. So these are a few virtues regarding the night of Laylatul Nisf in Sha'ban. Ibn Rajab al-Hanbali rahmatullahi says, there are many ahadith narrated in virtue of the 15th night of Sha'ban. Many of them are da'if and some of them are sahih, like Ibn Hibban has classed one of the ahadith sahih which we mentioned above. Anyhow, this night is classed as very virtuous, and among the tabi'een there were some who used to pay special attention to this night, especially from the people of Sham and Syria. Khalid ibn Ma'dan, Makhul Shami, Luqman ibn Amir, and others used to show great respect to this night, and they used to exhort themselves in worship, and from them people took this virtue of this night and showing respect to this night. Many among the other cities also agreed with them in showing respect to this night, especially the worshippers of Basra, which is a city in Iraq. They also used to show great esteem to this night as well. However, for the ulama of Hijaz, they would not pay much attention. From them was Ata and Ibn Abi Mulayka, as narrated by Ibn Rajab al-Hanbali rahmatullahi alayhi in the Taiful Ma'arif. How one should spend the night? Among the ulama of Sham, Khalid ibn Ma'dan, Makhul, there were some who used to gather in the masjid and we used to pray special salat with jamaat like we do so in Taraweeh. And they would wear special clothes, apply perfume, apply surma, and get ready for this night and spend it in worship. This was their habit. However, others say, number two, that not getting together for a special ibadat on this night, a person should himself do as much ibadat as he can on his own. This was the rai of Imam Awza'i rahmatullahi, who was also from the ulama of Sham. And Ibn Rajab says, وَهَذَا أَقْرَبُ, this is more closer to the sunnah. So these are some virtues regarding the night of 15th night of Sha'ban. How should we spend in worship? Rasulullah Pak sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's most favorite form of worship was salat. And he would offer salat abundantly as much as he could. So we should pray as much salat as we can. Aisha radiallahu anha says in one narration that on this night I was in search of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I noticed that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was in salat. And I heard him praying, in making dua in the sajda, Allahumma inni a'udhu bi'afwika min iqabik wa bi ridhaka min sakhatik wa bika minka jalla wajhu la uhsi thanaan alayk anta kama athnayta ala nafsi. In another narration, Rasulullah Pak sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked, Ya Rasulullah, if I were to find out when it is Laylatul Qadr, Shabi Qadr, what dua should I make? And he said, you should say, Allahumma innaka afuun tuhibbul afwa fa'afu anni. So the Shaykh Abdullah Muhaddis Dehlavi rahmatullah alayhi writes that if this dua is for Laylatul Qadr, then definitely we should make this dua in Laylatul Bara'at as well, because it is also a virtuous night. If you worship and do ibadat, make this dua. Also among the duas mentioned by Shaykh Abdullah Muhaddis Dehlavi rahmatullah alayhi is the dua of Sayyiduna Adam alayhi salam. When Adam alayhi salam cried and cried and cried to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, repented, his dua was, Allahumma innaka ta'lamu sirri wa alaniyati faqbal ma'zirati wa ta'lamu hajati fa'atini su'li. اللهم إني أسألك إيمانا يباشر قلبي ويقينا صادقا حتى أعلم أنه لا يصيبني إلا ما كتبت لي ورضا من المعيشة بما قسمت لي. Oh Allah, you know my secret condition and my open condition, and you know my needs, so please give me my need. Oh Allah, I ask you such iman and belief which which covers and envelopes and it gets inside my heart and covers it from all sides, all from, so my heart is filled with that iman, and I want that yaqeen and belief which is truthful, true yaqeen, so that I know that nothing will afflict me except what you have destined for me, and I want you to give me rida and happiness and be pleased and content with whatever rizq and whatever you have distributed for me. So give me these things. I ask you for these things. So this is dua mentioned with regards to the dua of Adam alayhi salam. When he made this dua, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised, O Adam, I forgive you and among your zurriyat and your progeny, whosoever pleads with me and supplicates with me in this manner, I will forgive him as well and fulfill his needs as well. So these are some of the du'as which we need to make on this night. And we should remember that this night is of special virtue. Umar ibn Abdul Aziz rahmatullahi alayhi, it is narrated from him that he would say that pay special attention to four nights, the first night of Rajab, 15th night of Shaban, and the two nights of Eid. This is narrated from Umar ibn Abdul Aziz. Imam Shafi rahmatullahi alayhi says, on five nights, du'as are accepted. The first night of Rajab, the 15th of Sha'ban, and Shabi Qadr, and the two nights of Eid. He also said, there are five nights, if a person stays awake on these nights, then his heart will not die at the time when people's hearts will die away. Meaning when people will be afflicted by fitnas, and their hearts will be dead, and they won't take good as good, virtue as virtue, they won't take bad as bad and evil as evil. This is the condition becomes when the heart is dead and it doesn't realize what is good, what is bad. It can't differentiate between virtue and vice. So this is the dying of the heart. So Imam Shafi'i Ramtullah says, if a person stays awake and prays and pleads to Allah on these nights, then his heart will not die on that day when people's hearts will die. Among them is Shabi Barad, Shabi Qadr, and the two Eids, and Laylatul Arafah. The night of Arafah is mentioned in that narration. So these nights are there is some significance and some importance to these nights. Ibn al-Arabi rahmatullahi alayhi has said in one place that Shabi Qadr, Laylatul Qadr, it revolves and turns around throughout the year. And I have seen it in different nights, and he narrates that once I have seen it in Shabi Barat as well. That Shabi Barat and Shabi Qadr both coincided with one another. So this is from Ibn al-Arabi. He experienced this. So maybe sometime, you never know, Some ulama have said, as the Shaykh Ramtullah has narrated, that there are Shabi Qadr is of two types. One is in which there is special noor and rahmat and barakah and thousands of angels coming down. In fact, Jibreel Amin alayhi salam also coming down in that Shabi Qadr. He also comes down to the earth on Shabi Qadr, even though Rasulullah has gone and Jibreel coming stopped. But on the night of Shabi Qadr, Jibreel alayhi salam also comes when Allah said, تَنَزَّلُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ وَالْرُوحُ فِيهَا. So Ruh reference is to Jibreel. So this is one Shabi Qadr, and another Shabi Qadr in which Allah decides matters and affairs. So one of them, it goes around in the month of Ramadan, and the other one goes around in throughout the year. So this is what's mentioned by Ibn al-Arabi maybe, that the one which moves around the year, he saw it in different parts of the year, and once he saw it in Shabi Barat as well, when it coincided with that. So this night is special night, and we should try and pray some special ibadat in there, make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ask him for forgiveness, give sadaqah and charity to our local community, local mosque, local masjid, local madrasa, or someone who is here from other place, and however manner we can help, if we can give out our zakat, we are ready, we have calculated our zakat, give our zakat in the night. If possible, go to the qabristan and pray for the deceased, like Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam went to Baqi in the hadith of Aisha radiallahu anha, and pray for them. If his qabristan, his graveyard is too far, then we can pray from wherever we are for the deceased and make dua for them. So these are the things to do in this night. And this night is very blessed. When we read the story of Malik ibn Dinar rahmatullah alayhi, how he did tawbah, his tawbah happened in this night. Malik ibn Dinar rahmatullah alayhi, a great wali of Allah, he says that in his earlier life he was not that pious, and he used to pray 5 times a day, but at the same time secretly sometimes he would drink as well, and alcohol. He says that I was leading a life of sin. I got married. Allah Pak blessed me with a girl, and she was extremely handsome. I was very fond of her. I used to play with her. She grew up. She started to walk. She started to jump on me, and I would love to play with her, and I was very fond with her. Something happened, and she suddenly died. And I was very grieved. And he says, it was the 15th night of Shaban. I came home. I had missed my Isha Salat as well. And I fell asleep. So I saw a dream that the Maidan of Hashr, the plain of resurrection, the resurrection has taken place. And people are coming out of their graves, and they are being called to the plain of resurrection and rushing towards their Maidan Hashr. Suddenly, I see some thundering noise behind me. I turn around, and there is a huge serpent, snake, running after me. So I was scared, terrified, and I ran. And I was running, and it was slithering behind me. I saw this old man in white clothes. I asked him, please, can you help me? The serpent is behind me. He said, I'm sorry, I can't help you. And he says, I saw a mountain. I climbed on that mountain, and this snake was behind me. When I reached at the top, I could see the Jahannam on the other side, the fire of Jahannam, the azab of Jahannam on the other side. I was so scared of the snake that I was about to jump in the fire. But someone stopped me, and I turned around, and I went back down from the other side. And the snake is still behind me. And I saw that white-clothed old man again. And I said, please help me. He said, I'm sorry, I can't help you. However, you see that hill, you go on that hill, there are some amanat and deposits of people. Maybe your amanat, your deposit is there as well. It might be able to help you. So I rushed towards the hill, and there was a palace, a mansion, and the gates were closed. But when I was running, the malaika called out, open the gates, open the gates. A person in distress is coming. Maybe he might have some deposit amanat over here. Help him. So they opened the gates, and there were small children inside, and they all rushed outside. Yeah. Among those children was my child as well. So she grabbed hold of me, and she made me sit on one place. She sat in my lap. In the meantime, the snake came closer. She stretched her hand out, and the snake went away. Wow. And then she got hold of my beard, and she said, أبا ألم يأن للذين آمنوا أن تخشع قلوبهم لذكر الله وما نزل من الحق. Has the time not come for those who have believed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that their hearts should humble before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and before the truth which Allah has revealed? So I asked her, Beta, do you read the Quran? She said, yes. All these children you see over here are all hafiz of Quran. When we die and we come over here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala appoints special teachers for us and we become hafiz. So I know the Quran, I am well versed with the Quran. And then she gave me some nasihat and some advice. And Malik bin Dinar rahmatullah alayhi says, I woke up. In that dream, I asked my daughter, what is this which I was looking at? And she told me that snake which was running after you are your sins, your bad deeds. You have made them so strong that they are pushing you into Jahannam, and they were about to push you and throw you into Jahannam. And that white old man in white clothes you saw, that was your good deeds. They are so weak that they are unable to help you Allah and take you into Jannah. However, They helped you in such a way that they guided you upon this hill. That is the only help they could were able to offer, and they guided you over here. So, dear father, now you must do tawbah, repent, and you must start doing some good deeds so you can strengthen your good deeds, and then you can go into Jannah. So Malik bin Dinar rahmatullah alayhi says, I woke up and I did complete tawbah from my life of disobedience, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed me, and then Malik bin Dinar went on to become one of the greatest awliyaullah, whose name is mentioned among the greatest saints. So closing the lesson, we have realized that alhamdulillah this night has some special virtue in it. We should try and spend in the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we should try and avoid those things which hinder and stop the maghfirat and rahmat being attracted towards us. Alhamdulillah, we are not doing shirk, we are muwahids, we believe in one Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The other matters were holding malice with a Muslim brother. Our hearts should be clean. Ibn Rajab al-Hanbali says, the biggest hatred a person can have is the hatred of Sahaba. So if a person has some hatred of Sahaba and he is Ravzi, or he is doing la'nat and cursing the Sahaba, he should do tawbah, because he will be the first one to be included in here. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us in Suratul Hashr, وَالَّذِينَ جَاءُوا مِن بَعْدِهِمْ يَقُولُونَ رَبَّنَا اغْفِرْ لَنَا وَلِإِخْوَانِنَا الَّذِينَ سَبَقُونَا بِالْإِيمَانِ. O Allah, forgive us and our those of our brothers who have passed with iman. وَلَا تَجْعَلْ فِي قُلُوبِنَا غِلًّا لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا رَبَّنَا إِنَّكَ رَؤُوفٌ رَحِيمٌ. O Allah, let there be no malice and hatred in our hearts for those who have believed. You are Ra'uf and Rahim. So those who have passed with iman, the first of our forefathers, ancestors who passed with iman are the Sahaba. So how can we have hatred with the Sahaba? After that, our hearts should be clean from the Aimma, from the Aimma-i Arba'a, and from Muhaddiseen, and from our Ulama and Sulaha. Some people abuse and swear at the Sahaba, backbite the Sahaba. Some say Abu Hanifa didn't know more than 15 hadith, and Abu Hanifa was like this. In some places, in some universities, someone wrote on the blackboard, Ya Aba Hanifa, inna bura'au minka. One teacher said, هذا مذهب حدثه الشيطان وهو مذهب أبي حنيفة. This مذهب was initiated by شيطان and it is the مذهب of Abu Hanifa. How can people say things like this regarding our Aim, our Aslaf? They are our elders. They were hafiz of Quran, they were hafiz of Hadith, they are Aimma. And so we should not have any hatred with regards to our Aimma or with regards to the Muhaddithin, Bukhari, Muslim, Tirmidhi, Abu Dawud, Ibn Majah, Nasa'i. They were all our elders. We should have love for them, have no hatred for them. And then have love for the ulama in our environment. The ulama, sulaha, mufti, anakiram, huffaz, aimma. We should have their love, have no hatred for them. And the love of the awamul muslimin as well. We should not have hatred of any Muslim in our hearts. Muslim brother is a brother. Al-Muslim akhul Muslim, Prophet said. A Muslim is a brother of a Muslim. We should have this brotherhood among us, not have any malice and hatred in our hearts for our fellow Muslim brothers. Otherwise, we will be prevented from this mafia. In fact, in one hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, on every Thursday, the a'mal of servants are raised to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah forgives everyone except for a person who has hatred in his heart for another Muslim brother and who are fighting among themselves. Allah says, leave them both until they do sulah and make peace among themselves. No. So when even every Thursday, they are not forgiven. Even on this night as well, they are not forgiven. Also, a person who hurts his parents, who disobeys his parents, a person who cuts off his relations and ties with his relatives, with his khala, with his pupi, with his mamu, with his chacha, with his uncles, aunties, and brothers. So we should join these kinships and not cut them off. Also, a person who is a murderer, he should do tawbah. If he is addicted to murdering and insisting on his murderous life, he's still engaged in this crime, he has not repented, he will not be forgiven on this night as well. Also, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned musbil, a person who lowers his garment, meaning he has pride and he has takabbur, haughtiness, proudiness in his heart, and he is arrogant. So a person who is arrogant, stubborn, haughty, he's not forgiven on this night as well. Create tawazu', humbleness, humility in your heart to attract the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, a person who is addicted to alcohol. So addiction to alcohol, drugs, these persons will not be forgiven. You have to do tawbah to attract the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, a magician who is doing magic on people. These are sins which Allah hates and Allah does not like. And that is why Allah said, these persons will be excluded from the maghfirat and rahmat which is descending upon the hearts in this night. Therefore, may Allah Pak give us the tawfiq to practice on what has been said and value and cherish this special night and do some ibadah and worship and remember our deceased, go to the graveyard, do some ibadat, and prepare for our hereafter, and prepare for the month of Ramadan. Some ulama have said that this 15th night is for preparation for Ramadan. That is why Rasulullah used to keep so many fasts in Sha'ban, so that he can get ready for Ramadan. So in Sha'ban he is keeping so many fasts that he is ready now, the nafs is ready. Otherwise what's happening is, when the Ramadan comes suddenly, then for the first few days, we get headaches, we feel dizzy, we feel odd, because we are not accustomed with roza, fasting. So Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam would habituate himself with fasting, so when Ramadan comes, he's ready, and he has that energy, strength to do fast. Ulama have said that a person can fast throughout Shaban, except 2-3 days before Ramadan. So 2-3 days before Ramadan, he should stop and he should get some energy and taqat and for the month of Ramadan. So fast throughout Ramadan, except for the last 2-3 days, and avoid, leave them, eat in there as much as you want, and then get ready for Ramadan and do your Ramadan fasting properly. Also read a little bit of Quran as well. Some ulama have said that it is mandub, mustahab to read lots of Quran throughout the month of Sha'ban to prepare for the month of Ramadan. If we pray much Quran now, then we can pray in Ramadan as well, get accustomed to reading of the Quran. May Allah Pak give us the tawfiq to practice. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله.
لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. لله. ل